Good afternoon. The first item of business is time for reflection. And our time for reflection leader today is Reverend Barry Hughes, Minister, St Mark's Parish Church, Raplock in Stirling.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Later today, I will be heading off to Loch Venica, just outside Callander in the Trossachs, where I will be joining the Raplock Primary School Primary 7 class for the rest of this week for their outdoor residential week. It's one of the greatest privileges of being parish minister in the Raplock that I'm able to work with the local schools, the teachers, the staff, and of course, most of all, the children themselves. I know that during this coming week, we will see the children grow in confidence. They will learn new skills. They will face challenges which will be new to them. And they will emerge from this week stronger as individuals and also as a class. And we, as adults in Scotland, could do well to learn from our children. Children are not encumbered by the things which can often hold us back as adults. Children will always embrace new opportunities with excitement and with enthusiasm, whereas our approach can sometimes be tainted with cynicism as adults. Jesus Christ knew this better than anyone. This is why he said in Mark's Gospel, "Let the little children come to me and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these." And he went on to add that all of us need to become like little children to enter the kingdom of heaven. Within our community of Raplock, children are offered many wonderful opportunities, not just by the local schools, but by organisations such as the Scouts and also the Big Noise, with which many of you will be familiar. But I'm also all too aware that there are too many children, not just in Raplock but across Scotland, whose opportunities can be limited by social and other factors. We owe it to all the children of Scotland, whatever their background, to ensure a quality of opportunity for them all. During the summer, I was privileged to be able to attend the World Scout Jamboree in South Korea, along with 35 scouts from central Scotland. We were known as the Kilted Kelpies, and 45,000 other scouts from around the world. As you may have seen on the news during July and August, it's fair to say that we faced a few wee challenges whilst we were in Korea. But we were so proud of all of the young people who attended from Scotland for the resilience and the adaptability and the positivity which they showed throughout these challenges, and for the attitude which they showed, which was always a can-do attitude. Presiding Officer, as I pray this week for God's blessing on you and all in this place, I do so remembering the words of Jesus Christ. "When you welcome children in my name, you welcome me also." Thank you.
Thank you, Reverend. Thank you very much. Thank you.